Roger, it's halfway through the 2014 migration here at Redbird at the Skyport. Obviously, a lot of interesting discussions, but more important than anything else, a chance to kind of look back and decide whether or not you learned anything this year. So, did you?
Yeah, absolutely. First of all, you know, we started out, as we talked about last migration, proving the value of the simulators and answering some basic questions that we may have thought was obvious to begin with, but do we have, you know, actual data now that we can support that? And as that is, can you reduce training times by using simulation? And the answer is, of course you can. Can you reduce customer frustration? Of course you can. Can you teach instrument skills in the simulator? Well, we've been doing that for years. And another big question is, can you teach VFR maneuver skills in the simulation devices that actually translate to flying the airplane? And the answer is, of course you can. So I think we've proven with our data that everything we started out to do with the fidelity of the simulators now and teaching all the things we need to know for flight, we've certainly proved that. There is no doubt in anybody's mind, I think, that you have to build intrinsic skills as part of your flying. And until you build those intrinsic muscle skills, you're not going to have enough available RAM memory to actually perceive the environment and react to it, which is really the important part about the flying. And the simulator is a much better place to do that because it's replicable over and over. So we did that. I learned some other things as well in that I was off for a few months spearheading the development of the Red Hawk project. And even though it's just down the street by, you know, a couple hundred yards, it seemed like a long distance. And when I came back, I found out that in doing some flight tests that my first time pass rates were going down and still well within margin, but you know, that upset me quite a bit. And I found out it wasn't in the maneuvers basis, the simulator was doing a good job of that, it was in the ground portion of the practical test. And it was because perhaps well-meaning but not very well-understanding instructor had started introducing more superfluous material into it to the point where the learners had become task saturated and then layered on more after that. So as a result of that, I have gone back, re-emphasized, retrimmed, refocused the syllabus. That syllabus now focuses on what is relevant for you to know what to fly and then goes into a much greater depth of your understanding of the material so that when you do go fly, you are going to be very well prepared to deal with all the kinds of situations you can deal with in the real world. That's the advantage of the simulator. So along came that in that we've done a lot of work in the advisory group in Washington on the airman certification standards replacing the PTS. All of that has happened extremely fast. The FAA has been behind this effort 100%. So it just was a good opportunity to roll in the concept of, you know, a combined knowledge, skills, and risk management into our curriculum anyway, and that's what I am finishing up now. So our ground training will all be ACS compliant by 1 January, and you've seen the trace technology that we're using not only to teach maneuvers, but that trace technology is now going to expand quickly into doing the ground training lessons as well, so you get a predictable, consistent, focused message for every single learner. That'll all take place in the first quarter of 2015.
Do you think the industry, though, gets what you're doing? Do you think they're coming to a point where they're really beginning to, one, focus their attention and comprehending what you're trying to accomplish and ultimately what you're learning?
You know, I hope so. When we started this concept 4 years ago, I don't think that the general aviation industry really had embraced simulation as a way to teach. And I'm not saying, you know, larger schools or university programs or programs that had attracted people who had used advanced simulation in military training and whatnot. I mean, they've always been on the edge of that. But I mean, your average general aviation Part 61 flight school had not really understood the value of simulation. And I think now over the efforts we've made in the last couple of years, that advantage is undeniable. Now, whether or not they want to jump on board or to what degree they want to jump on board, I don't think anymore is a question about whether it's a good idea. It's a question about, can I afford it and how do I do the transition? But I think the message is out there now.
Interesting stuff. We look forward to catching up with you next year and finding out what you've learned by then.
Yeah, that's like next week, right? So we'll take care of it.
Thank you very much. All right.
Aero-TV is brought to you by...
Finally, the extraordinary story of the world-changing XPRIZE space competition is being told and illustrated with hundreds of insider photos in Jim Campbell's colorful new book, Beyond the Blue. Journey with Jim as he flies formation with spaceships plays in zero gravity, prepares rocket racers, and documents the amazing first decade of the personal space race. Available this summer. Get your advance order in now by checking out www.kindredspirit.com.